Well, next time you get the bright idea of selling everybody in the same horse, do it with your own money.
Well, it wasn't my fault. They were all following Chrissie.
Someone sure as hell jinxed me. Look, here's the payout list.
You pay out everybody?
Of course I do. I'm paying you enough, aren't I? You might as well earn it. And don't bugger up the payout.
So I must ask you, Burns, what it is you're really doing wandering around the corridors?
Well, I already told...
Get over against that wall. Put your arms up. Keep them there.
I haven't done anything.
Shut up. Put your arms down.
Can I go now?
No. Well, well, well. Must be nearly $500 here. I shouldn't imagine you'd have seen that much money in your entire life, Burns.
It's not mine.
You don't say.
Well, what I meant to say was that I've never seen it before in my life, and someone must have planted it on me, honest.
Don't take me for a fool, Burns. And you'd better show a bit more respect, because if you don't, I'm going to see you put in solitary, and you'll stay there till you rot.
I haven't done anything.
You're a fool, Burns. And I don't have anything to do with fools. Now get moving.
I told you.
Well, you can tell it again, and maybe you'll have better luck next time. Now move. All right, you lot, get a move on, unless you want to join her. Now. Let's see what the governor has to say, Burns. Move!
She's a real little lady now, Jude. You ought to see her.
Yeah, I bet she's as cute as a button.
Yeah.
Well, that's why I don't want that bitch Brenda having her. I'd see her.
Guess what? Poor old Dora's copped it again. I just saw Fergo dragging her off to Dover.
What did Doreen say? I mean, what's Fergo got her for?
Oh, how the hell should I know? I didn't stick around to find out. All I know is Doreen must have been collecting the laundry.
Oh, Fergo... no. Oh, now I'm really stuffed.
You're stuffed? Doreen's the one that's on the carpet.
She's got the money. The payout money. You saw me give it to her in the workshop. She put it in the laundry basket. Ferguson must have found it.
Oh, no.
Are you talking about our winnings, our money?
Well, it's not my bloody fault.
So, it was our winnings, was it?
I suppose now we're all going to be out of pocket.
Not me. I got 18 bucks coming to me and I want it.
Yeah, 20 of it's mine.
Now, just a minute, girls. She owes us all money. What are you going to do about it?
Well... I can't pay you if I haven't got it, can I?
Well, you'd better get it, and get it fast, or else some of us might get nasty. Real nasty.
Hey, take it easy. I didn't say I wasn't going to pay you. I just said I can't until I get the money, that's all.
It's the same thing.
No, it's not. I never welched on a bet in my life. I can cover me bets. I just need a few hours.
Yeah, well, that sounds reasonable to me.
Oh, what? Just a few hours?
Yeah.
Okay. But if you don't have our money by tonight, you'd better find a bloody good place to hide.
You are being very stupid, Doreen. It is in your own interest to tell me where you obtained this money. I already told you, I've never seen it before.
That is not acceptable, particularly in view of Miss Ferguson's evidence. You are quite satisfied that this money is the proceeds of illicit gambling, Miss Ferguson?
I can only repeat what I saw, Governor. I overheard the women listening to a horse race, and it seemed obvious that someone might be running a book. I kept my eyes open for anything unusual, and then I intercepted Burns carrying the money.
Do you have anything to say?
Well, betting on horses is a mug's game. I don't go much for it myself.
It would be much easier for you if you would just tell us the names of those involved.
I don't go much for lagging neither.
Very well, I can see I'm wasting my time. Your loyalty to your friends is very commendable, Burns.
It's not that. I just don't know anything.
When a prisoner is found with the outrageous sum of $95 on their person, I can only assume...
$95, but...
Yes, Burns, you have something to say?
No, Mrs. Davidson, nothing you'd want to hear.
Very well. This money will be confiscated, and you will spend 2 days in solitary for your involvement. Thank you, Miss Ferguson.
Yes, Governor.
Miss Ferguson, may I commend you on your excellent handling of this matter?
Thank you, Governor.
So I've got you down to work Wednesday night, which gives you Thursday morning off. Okay?
Good.
Thank you. Well, you are Hannah Dale Simpson, is that correct?
That's right.
Stand on the line. Hannah Dale Simpson, you are charged with armed robbery and are to be held on remand pending a hearing to answer this charge. Do you understand?
Yes, perfectly.
Do you have any money or valuables on you?
No, nothing.
Right. Well, you'll be fingerprinted, taken to the showers before you're shown to your cell.
Whatever you say.
It's almost time for the evening meal. You'll meet the other inmates there.
I'll give it a miss if you don't mind. I've already eaten.
All right. Mrs. Ward, will you take charge? Yeah, well, she seems to be a pretty cool customer. Wonder how cool she'll stay after a few days of Wentworth hospitality.
Gotta get some money from somewhere. Just gotta.
Talking to yourself, Faye.
Or to one of your contacts.
Hi. What are you lot doing in here?
Give you three guesses. Have you got our money?
Well, no, not exactly. I...
Close the door, Phil.
Look, I haven't got it, but I can get it. I mean, it's all under control, see? I just need more time.
Time has just run out.
Oh, no!
Gee, it looks as though someone bashed into Faye.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Oh, well, you can't blame them. I mean, we've all lost a packet because of her.
And what happened to you, Quinn? Run into a door, I suppose.
Something like that.
Yes, of course.
I see Lil and her mates try to rearrange your face.
Yeah, that's just for starters. Stokesy reckons I'm going to get a kicking every night until I cough up the money.
Oh, Lil wouldn't have the brains of a stuffed wombat. It's not your fault Doreen got sprung.
I told him that. I'd pay him the money if I had it, honest.
Yeah, never mind. I'll speak to the girls, tell them to lay off you.
You? Why would you do that? What's in it for you?
Don't look a gift horse in the mouth, Faye. A top dog looks after everyone, including you. Besides, I decide who gets heavy around here.
All right, you lot, let's see how you scrub up in the shower. Come on, get moving. I'll give it to you straight. Lay off her, or I will personally bash some sense into your skulls.
It's not fair.
Why should we lose our money?
Oh, wake up to yourselves. What do you think this place is, Fairyland? We're lucky to have a book going at all. Now, Faye is running a lot of risk-taking bets. And I think we should take some chances too, don't you? Okay, we were rolled. It's lousy luck. But don't go blaming the bookie.
Okay.
I suppose so.
Get out of here.
Okay, Faye, you can relax. The girls said they were sorry.
Oh, Tabby, that's one I owe you.
It's okay. Oh, God, I'm getting sick of this. It's all going to have to come off. Come on, you lot who haven't finished your shower, get a move on. We haven't got all day.
All right, come on. You're allowed 5 minutes in the shower. Try and keep to it.
Who's the new one?
Simpson. Came in last night.
Huh?
Strange one. Haven't worked her out yet. Rather cold.
Really?
All right, everyone. That is Hannah Simpson. I'm sure you've all got a lot in common.
G'day. How you going?
Hello, love. What you in for, then?
Oh, she's up herself.
Be a sorter out.
Yeah.
Come on, you lot. Let's go.
Think she is cutting us dead like that.
Yeah, she's no better than the rest of us, otherwise she wouldn't be
Quinn,
in here.
The prospect of everyone in here being no better than you is turning my stomach. Now get in there and clean that cell up. You miss out on breakfast.
Hello, Miss Ferguson. I didn't see you.
Obviously not. It's all right, Birdsworth. You can smoke. Been here a long time, haven't you?
Half my life. It's me home.
So naturally, you'd know everything that goes on.
I know a lot more than most people around here. But I mind my own business, and I don't want any trouble.
Husband?
No. Just an old mate. He died.
How long's the book been running?
Oh, age. Book? Oh, I don't know about any book.
I'm not stupid, Birdsworth. Your friend Burns is already in the pound. I wouldn't have thought she'd be the type to run a book.
She isn't. She's only a...
Faye Quinn? Well, we'll be seeing a lot of each other, Birdsworth. I've enjoyed our little chat. Keep your ears open.
I'm no bloody lagger.
Our money that's missing. If you've got any complaints, give them to
Dee.
She'll take care of you.
Ah,
don't push it, Quinn. Your luck's not
going to
last forever, you know.
I want to see you, Quinn. Well, how many
Quinns are there? Move. I haven't done nothing.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. Unless you call running the book in a place of this size nothing.
Me? I've got nothing to do with it.
Oh. Well, then I guess this must belong to someone else. You can almost taste it, can't you, Quinn?
What you gonna do about it?
That depends. I've got no objections to you running the book. Providing I get my cut.
You?
Yeah, that's right. Don't worry, I'll earn it. I can make it easy for you to move around the prison. My eyesight's not too good when it suits me.
You're right.
Where's your manners, Quinn?
Yes, please, Miss Ferguson.
That's better. Thirty. 40. 45. 50.
50 bucks out of 500? You want a bloody big cut?
It's because I'm a big girl. You want to make something of it?
No.
Because I had to give Mrs. Davidson some to cover myself. Now, have we got a deal?
Yeah, we got a deal.
Good. That's very wise of you, Quinn. But then, I thought you'd be reasonable about it.
What's that hurry up? My stomach's rumbling.
I wonder what Ferguson cornered Faye for.
Madam Lash. She's probably putting the hard word on her.
It's so funny.
Nothing.
What did Ferguson want?
Oh, nothing. Just told me to clean up my cell.
Pity you didn't clean up your racket.
Look, if you reckon you're so hard done by, I'll give you a chance to get your money back. Honey, you've got to give me a fair go too.
Why are you going to pay us if you're broke?
Yeah, what's the catch? There's no catch. I've got somebody who'll cover me bets. But only $1 bets and longest odds 5-1.
What? God, the odds are stacked in your favour.
Look, you know I'm flat broke and there's nothing in the bank. You've got to give me a chance to get back on my feet.
I suppose so. It's better than nothing.
Well, it's more than I can say for breakfast.
So, how's things?
Oh, pretty good.
She's going to start up the book again.
Oh.
Yeah, well, I was sick of everybody whinging. Good on you, love. I love a bit of a flutter. Hey, there's that Simpson girl. What do you reckon? You think she'd like a bit of a bet?
No. She's a weirdo, that one.
Oh, maybe she's just a little bit shy. I'll tell you what. I'll interview her for the stew. That way I can get a few tidbits for me column. That'll bring her out of her shell.
Leave her alone, Lizzie, right now. She just doesn't want to know. And as long as she stays out of our business, that's fine by me.
You don't want her to think you're a bit of a snoop now, do you?
That's not snooping. I'm a newspaper woman. I've got a good nose for news.
What are you lot plotting then?
Right now, Lizzie is hot on the trail of nothing. Madam here's opening a book.
Yeah? Blimey, you're game, ain't you? I wouldn't fancy my chances with a book with Fergo hanging around.
Oh, well, she's trying to prove she's indispensable, aren't you, Faye?
Oh, just have to be extra careful, that's all.
I reckon Ferguson's all right. Oh, hark at the voice of experience.
Well, I reckon if a screw takes a shine to you, then you're gonna be all right.
I don't think you're her type, Lizzie.
What do you mean?
Oh, come on, Lizzie.
What? She's as butch as they come.
God. I must be slipping. Are you sure?
Lizzie, she makes my friends on the outside look like Julie Andrews. She's a big, bad, bald bike, mate. You'd do well to keep her away from her. Oh, I don't know. Could be Andy.
At the lot?
Lizzie's going to be a rubber ball if she misses out.
Well, I can't be everywhere, can I?
And somebody's got to take the laundry basket.
Yeah, well, don't worry. I'll work out Lizzie. Wrap it. Let's go fast.
I think you've been waiting for this.
Yeah, I have. Thanks.
You're wasting your time. It's not in there. I've already looked.
Oh, well. Can't win them all.
Obviously. Well, okay. There's no reason for you all to stop work. Come on, get on with it.
I'm sorry, love. I know how you must feel.
No, don't worry. I told you it was no good.
It was damn good, and you know it.
Do I? And what yardstick have I got? Maybe I can't write.
Well, if you can't write, then how come the Dispatch used all your other articles?
Oh, sensationalism. Everyone wants to read about victimisation and wrongful imprisonment. That's why they lapped up those pieces on Helen and Susie. It sells papers.
Yeah, well, once the public know what's really going on...
The public don't want to know. We're an embarrassment to them. They talk about punishment and rehabilitation, but they don't really want to read about the loneliness and the humiliation of having no privacy and the endless years of boredom. Well, hell, would you?
No, but it's all the truth.
Yeah. Sure, it's true. And that's what frightens them. We're on our own in here, Jude. As far as the public are concerned, we could all drop dead.
So I've been in and out most of my life. This is your first time, isn't it?
Yes.
I got put in for murder.
but I never done it. What are you in for?
Look, I'd rather not talk about it.
All right, Birdsworth, get on with your work.
Righto. See you later, then.
In case you hadn't guessed, that's the local sticky beak.
I had guessed.
Of course, you can't blame her for being interested. You're a very interesting lady. Clever how you got those men to do the job for you. Then I should imagine you could get anything you wanted, if you really tried. So can I. Patience is one of my virtues, Hannah.
Simpson, the police are here. They want to interview you. As you're on remand, you don't have to see them, but
then
I would suggest...
Won't.
Very well, I'll let them know. That's not a Christmas file, is it?
Well, yes. I was doing some homework.
No files are allowed out of reception.
Oh, I am sorry, Mrs. Powell. I'll put it right back.
Yeah, try your luck with the receptionist.
What was that remark?
Nothing at all.
I assume that whatever you said was directed at Officer Ferguson.
I don't want any trouble.
Then don't provoke it. Listen, Simpson. I'm the deputy governor here, and I demand respect for my officers. Now, if you're convicted, you could be here for a very long time, so I wouldn't go and make any enemies.
Come on, Bea, what you doing?
I don't know yet. I haven't asked the expert. What's the good word, Chrissie?
Oh, let's just say I've put a dollar on Churchet's La Femme.
What is that, a horse or a recipe? Come on, give us some money.
I'm with Chrissie.
Right, ladies, that's it. Book's closed on the first.
Hang on a minute, why don't you wait for me?
Sorry, Lizzie, book's closed.
Bloody cheek. I always have first bet. Ask anyone.
Oh, that's all right, Lizzie. I put a bet on for you and Doreen. It was Matchbox you wanted, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Ha-ha. You little beauty.
What about the second race, Faye?
Book will open in 5 minutes, as soon as I get a chance to tally this lot.
This is going to be my shot. I'm going to put a bet on for you and Dore.
Oh, thanks, Lizzie.
Oh, I'm a bit short of cash. Could you lend me a couple of bucks? Oh, I'll pay you
back.
Yeah,
all right, but I don't have any cash on me. I have to go to my cell and get some.
God. I tell you what, if I go all right on these, I'll up the limit to $2 on the third, okay?
Oh, gee whiz, you're all half.
Don't anyone up anything till Jude brings back the dough.
Oh, God, it's gone. Oh.
I'll have a dollar on Crackling Rosie.
Can only give you threes. The second favourite.
Well, it's 5-1 in the paper.
Would you like to take your business elsewhere, Phil?
Wonder where Jude's got to.
Don't worry, Lizzie. Your credit's good. Till lunchtime, anyway.
Screw!
Oh, time for walkies, kids.
All right. Smith, Hunt, Stokes, off to the kitchen. Rest of you outside for your morning exercise.
Oh, it's hot in here, isn't it?
Then I suggest you get some fresh air with the others.
Oh, I don't feel up to it. I've got this splitting headache. It's my little girl, you see. My sister-in-law won't bring her in to see me.
So?
So, if someone was to do a little favour for me, go and see her, make her come in. I'd own one, wouldn't I? And I always pay my debts.
And you've got a headache.
Oh, yeah. I've got some tension knots all round the back here, look. Oh. Oh, yeah, that's just what I needed. Oh, do you know, I can feel all a little flutter in my stomach. You and I've got strong hands, haven't you?
Better?
Oh, yeah. Here, don't stop, will you?
And how's this? How's the flutter in your stomach now, Latham?
Oh, stop it, please,
oh,
stop!
Filthy slut. You'd use anyone, wouldn't you? Well, you picked wrong this time. I don't roll in the gutter with anyone. Now, get out.
shares just like medicine to these old lungs. What's so funny?
You raving on about fresh air and sucking on a fag.
Well, you got to do it gradual. I mean, too much fresh air suddenly is no good for you, eh? Where have you been? Faye's waiting for that money.
Yeah, well, you're going to have a long wait. The money's gone.
Gone?
You mean it's been pinched?
It was there before. It's not there now. Work it out for yourself.
Hell, all of us have got personal stuff stashed away. None of us is safe.
Yeah, that's what I'm worried about.
Hey, what's the mother's meeting about, then?
Somebody went into Jude's room and pinched her stash.
Oh, well, nothing surprises me in this bleeding old.
Yeah, well, we better give whoever it is a going over when we find out.
You reckon it was one of us?
Well, who else could it be?
Yeah, it could have been a screw. Well, they got access to the cells, didn't they? And black leather gloves don't leave fingerprints, do they?
You think it was Miss Lucas?
Look, I'm not saying nothing, Lizzie. All I am saying is that you can't trust a screw.
Mm. Well, she's right.
Can't go into each other's rooms on our own when there's nobody about. The only people who can do that are the remand prisoners and
what
the
did
screws.
You say?
I just said that the remand...
Remand prisoners? Who do we know, girls, eh? Who's a remand prisoner?
Hannah.
Yeah, why not? She's had plenty of chance while we've been working.
And she's an uppity little bitch who couldn't give a bugger about any of us. And I'll tell you what, I'd be willing to lay odds that she's the tea leaf.
Okay, that's ham and pineapple. It's an Hawaiian.
Hi. Well, you look like an expert already. How's it going?
Oh, not crash hot. I was a lot better at the hamburgers.
Don't listen to her. She's doing great. Best we've ever had for a first day.
You didn't take long, did you?
Who's he? Oh, that's Jack. He's been real nice to me.
I bet he has. I'd say he really fancies you.
Oh, Mandy, he does not.
I bet he asks you out.
Well, stop it, will you? You're putting me off my work.
Okay, I just wanted to wish you luck. See you later.
Bye. See you tonight.
All right, the orders are coming in thick and fast. That's two marinara.
Marinara.
That's prawns, clams, anchovies, olives.
Anchovies. Oh, I'll never get the hang of it.
Quinn? Sorting out my cut for the day.
Oh, give me a chance. I've got to build up my bank after you clean me out.
All right. Don't cross me. I promise you, you'll be sorry.
We'll be lucky if either of us gets anything. There's a rotten thief going around dipping into everything.
Thief? One of the women?
We haven't figured that out yet.
I see. I noticed Simpson wandering around the corridors when you're all at work. Pity you can't lock your doors.
We thought it might have been her. That rotten...
Calm down. I'm not saying it was her. But if it was, I'm sure you all have ways of dealing with that sort of thing.
Oh, hello, Mr. Faulkner.
Ladies, how's everything going?
Really good.
Glad to hear it, Lizzie.
I think he's got a bit of a soft spot for me.
Yeah, in his head. Why does he have to go around being so bleeding cheerful all the time? You'd think this place would give him the willies.
Oh, I think he's used to it now. And I reckon he likes a bit of female company. He and Sandy Edwards were... You know.
You mean he was having it off with her in here?
They were kicking the footy around for a while.
That's bloody typical, that is. I suppose he thought he could get away with it because we're in no position to complain.
No, you got it all wrong. It was Sandy Edwards who fancied him, and you can't blame a bloke for taking what's offered.
Well, I'll be... So Stevie boy was getting laid by one of us, was he? Oh, what a turn-up.
Oh, don't laugh. He's a good bloke and he's real helpful to us most of the time, which is more than you can say for most of the screws.
Helpful, is he? Well, we haven't been formally introduced, but maybe you'd like to do a little favour for me. I can be good company as well.
What sort of a favour?
I reckon a visit from your Mr. Faulkner
is all Brenda needs to get her off her arse and in here, quick smart.
Hey, I've got to talk to you. It's urgent. We'll be late for work.
Oh, Lizzie, go on. I just want to have a natter with Faye, that's
all. Well, nobody ever tell me anything anymore.
All right, then, what's going on?
You were dead right about Simpson. It was her that nicked Jude's money.
How do you know?
Well, I can't tell you, but I'm real sure.
Right, that settles it. I knew she was no bloody good soon as I saw her.
Where are you going?
To sort her out, good and proper. You coming?
Yeah, all right.
What are you doing in here?
We just come for a little chat with you, darling.
Didn't anyone ever teach you to knock?
No.
You've got a big mouth for a rotten thief.
What?
Come on, hand over Jude's money and you won't get hurt.
I don't know anything about any money.
Oh. All right, lady, you asked for it.
What?
You...
All right, what the hell's going on in here?
Latham, I might have known. And you, Quinn, whatever made you think you could get away with a stunt like this?
Well, she's a rotten...
Shut up, Quinn. You've behaved like scum. But that's all right. Because now I know how to treat you. And when I get through with you, you're going to be very, very sorry.
If you two had a brain between you, you'd know that I don't care enough about any of you to bother stealing from you. I just want to be left alone. Is that too much to ask?
You're not in the same class as this girl. And I intend to make sure that none of you ever get close to her again. Now get out!
Idiots!
It's all right, Hannah. I'm here now.
Do you mind? Look, I know what you want, but you picked on the wrong person. Just leave me alone!
Stop right there, Simpson.
No, I won't stop. I don't want any part of this place or the people in it, and that goes for you. But if I had to make a choice, I'd sooner be bashed by them than put up with your filthy paws all over me.
All right, Simpson. I get your message. Now you get mine. You don't have a choice. Understand? In here, I can make or break you. And sooner or later, I intend to have you.
Hi, I'm up to my ears in it.
Oh, Mandy, you were right.
What?
Oh, Jack, he asked me out tonight.
What?
Oh, that's fantastic. Yeah, we're going to a disco.
Yeah.
Only...
Oh, I see what you mean. Well, what else have you got?
Only this.
Oh. It's nice, but it's not exactly...
It's not exactly disco gear. Yeah, I know. Well, what am I going to do? You haven't got anything.
Well, I'm in the same boat myself. They haven't got any discos in Katandra.
Well, hey, I've got some pink dacks you can borrow. Hey, yeah, what about these?
Great. See, misery, we're halfway there already. But you can't go topless. Wait a minute.
Hey, what about this? Oh, it's a shirt Helen gave me.
Well, with this and those shoes and those dacks, you look fantastic.
Well, that's it. 3 hours to unwind before I come back.
Lucky you.
Well, I'll be off then. Oh, Miss Ferguson, there's a prisoner's letter there on the desk. I think Mrs. Powell must have dropped it when she distributed the others this morning.
Oh, that's all right, Wendy. I'll take care of it. Who's it for?
Chrissie Latham.
I'll take it to her if you like.
No, I'll take it to her when I come back. It's the best way to help me remember who they are.
Well, good night then.
Wendy.
Yes, Steve?
Well, seeing we had such a good time last night, I was wondering if you'd like to come out and see the yacht.
Don't you think it'd be a bit crowded?
Sorry?
I mean, with me and Mrs. Morris and God knows how many other women.
Don't be silly, just the two of us.
I'll think about it. Night.
Love wasn't meant to be easy.
Bloody thing ran second last. Wasting me bloody money.
Well, I upped the limit, like I said.
Oh, you really sucked us in. But don't worry, it won't happen next time.
I don't know how you lot can sit there raving about a bloody horse race when that rotten little thief Simpson's out on her todd nicking everything she can get her hands on.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to stick my neck out and accuse her. We don't know it was Hannah.
Of course we do. Me and Faye just about got a confession out of her. Till that butch cow Ferguson broke it all up.
Why didn't Ferguson put you on report?
Well, she's got her own form of justice, that's why. I wouldn't turn me back on her for quids. She's got her own rules, that one.
Yeah, just the same. I don't reckon Anna would have confessed.
Oh, you two-faced little... It was you what told me you had the proof she'd done it.
Well, maybe I was wrong. It's not against the law, you know. Anyway, the person who told me turned out to be a bloody liar.
Codswallop, of course she done it.
Well, if she didn't do it, who did?
That's right. If you got proof, okay. If you haven't, will you shut up about it?
I'm telling you, the thief's in her cell right now. All you got to do is to go and get her.
How come you're so sure?
I'll tell you how I'm so sure, Lizzie. I've had money nicked and all. I had $5 hid in my cell, and whilst we was all working, it's gone.
Why didn't you say so before?
Yeah, you've never mentioned it.
Well, you were all so busy being so bloody holy about letting her off the hook, I knew I'd be wasting me time.
Oh, we still don't know that Hannah did it.
Look, if you lot don't want to do nothing about it, okay, but I don't have to sit here and listen to it. I'm going to me cell. You lot are giving me the tom tits.
Hi. You look down the dumps.
I'll never understand women.
Certainly hope not. That'd soon put an end to all the fun, wouldn't it? Well, what's happened?
I went out with Wendy last night and we had a great time. But today she's given me the cold shoulder. She seems to think there's something going on between you and me.
Well, I can't say I'm surprised. Colleen's pulled my leg about it a couple of times.
It's ridiculous. You spend the day at my place and the rumours start to fly.
I wouldn't worry about it. People always find something to gossip about.
Maybe we should start a mutual admiration society.
Right, but not until I've had a cup of coffee.
I'll join you when I finish my rounds.
Fine.
Mr. Faulkner, you got a minute?
What do you want, Leith?
Oh, just a little chat, that's all.
Well?
Well, we haven't had much of a chance to get to know each other yet, have we? The other girls, they all reckon you're something special, you know. And I reckon they're right. You certainly do brighten up the scenery.
Get to the point, Latham.
Well, I heard as how you'd helped them out. You know, done them little favours now and then.
So?
Well, it's Elizabeth, see, me daughter. My sister-in-law's got her, and I can't get through to her. What I need is someone with a bit of clout to go round there and make her bring her in regularly, you know.
Mrs. Davidson would be the one to organise something like that.
No, it won't work. Mrs. Morris tried that and it did no good. No, what it needs is for someone to go round there personal-like and make her bring her in. Besides, I reckon you and me have got things in common.
Such as?
Such as... I think you and me would be good company for each other. I've heard about you and Sandy Edwards, you know. And I really know how to make a man happy.
That's enough, Latham.
Oh, well, why don't you just have a little think about it, eh? I bet we'd have more fun than you do with Meg Morris.
Another word and you'll be put on report.
I don't think so, Mr. Faulkner. What would Mrs. Davidson say if she knew what you and Meg Morris get up to on night shift, eh? Think about it. I could show you a real good time. Well, now Edwards is gone. He's playing mums and dads with Meg Morris, isn't he? Here, it's no wonder she's going around with that stupid grin on her face all the time.
Yeah. I suppose she's grateful for what she can get. They reckon her old man walked out on her. Yeah.
Latham? A letter for you. I'm surprised you know anyone who can write.
She waits till now to bring you your letter. We all got ours this morning.
Oh, I don't know, rotten bitch. She probably hid it.
No. What's up? You look like you've seen...
No, she can't!
Chrissie,
no,
what the hell's happened?
She can't do this, she can't. It's Brenda. She's applied for legal custody of Elizabeth.
What? She can't do that.
Oh, can't she? You tell her that. I won't ever get to see her now. But
the time I get out of there, she won't even know who I am.
Well, can't you stop her?
How? I'd go over the fence if I thought it would help. Oh, God. What am I going to do?
Oh, Chrissie. Oh, no, you'll make yourself sick.
Oh, Faye, I love that little girl. I can't lose her. Oh. I can't.
Oh, I can't believe it. It's fantastic.
This is just the beginning. Come on, let's dance.
Hello, Jono. I must say, you're tasting brute. Hi, I'm Greg.
Susie.
Yeah, come on, nick off, Dirk. Susie's with me.
Everybody's entitled to one mistake. Hey, come on, Susie, how about a dance?
Well, remember me?
Oh, sorry, guys. I gotta go. See you around, Susie.
Hey, does everyone carry on like him?
Only when it's a girl like you. Come on, how about that dance, eh?
I don't know. Everyone will look at me.
Well, of course they will. You look terrific. Come on.
Good night, Jude. Sweet dreams.
Yeah. I'm going to have a wonderful dream tonight about a fabulous pair of legs.
Yeah?
Yeah. On a turkey with all the stuffings.
All right, ladies, into yourselves, please.
Hey, Mrs. M, are you and Mr. Faulkner going to be on together all night? On night shift, I mean.
Yeah, of course she does.
No, Quinn, I'm just about to finish for the night.
Oh, too bad for Mr. Faulkner. He'll be real lonely without you.
All right, you've had your little joke.
Yeah, that's enough. Shut up, the lot of you.
Oh, thank you, Lizzie.
Well, that's all right. It's none of our business anyway. But you do look really romantic. You make a lovely couple.
Lizzie, I think this has gone far
she
enough.
She didn't mean anything by it, Mrs. Morris. No, she's just an old romantic.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, we won't talk about it anymore if you don't want us to, will we, girls?
No, never. What you do is your own affair.
You sure you won't get into trouble? It's after midnight.
Oh, I don't care. I'm not going to let old Batface spoil the best night of my life.
Yeah. I had a great time too. Everyone thought you were a knockout. How about Saturday night?
Oh, sure. But I'll see you tomorrow at work, won't I? I suppose I better go in.
Yeah, I suppose.
I better go.
Hey, how are you going to get in? I mean, if you ring the bell...
You'll see.
Where did you learn that?
A dear old mate called Lizzie taught me. She was really special. See? Oh, I better go. Good night. And thanks again.
I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Well, young lady, and what have you got to say for yourself?
Well, I was...
You come home over an hour late. You pick the lock and then try to sneak in. I am disappointed, Susan. Very disappointed. My girls have never given me this trouble in the past. I've always had every reason to be proud of them. Until now.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Bennet.
I should think so. This is a respectable establishment. We do not allow behaviour like that here. Kindly remember that in the future.
Yes, Mrs. Beamish.
Very well. Go to your room and try not to wake Amanda.
Oh, bloody thing! Psh. Oh, Mr. Faulkner.
What's the matter, Lizzie?
I can't sleep. This bloody pillow's got bricks in it. Can I have one of me pills?
All right, I'll get it from the dispensary next time round.
Ta.
Mr. Faulkner, is that you?
What do you want, Latham?
Look, I'm sorry about what I said before. I wasn't thinking. It's just that I need someone. Just for a little while, just to have a chat. I promise I won't...
I told you before, Latham, you're wasting your time.
I just want to talk, honestly. You see, they're going to take my little girl away from me and I can't... Somebody's got to help me! Oh, come back, you bastard! I'll tell them that you laid me! Mr. Faulkner? Oh, Mr. Faulkner, I didn't mean it. Mr. Faulkner!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes.